Welcome to This Just In, a weekly news show highlighting the people and events in Newport News Public Schools. WHRO designated 9 Hampton Roads Title I schools as super reader schools, and Carver Elementary is proud to be the only school selected in Newport News. Throughout the school year, Carver will receive professional development, parent trainings, family literacy nights, and valuable resources. And recently, Carver's young students in kindergarten and first grade enjoyed a special educational visit from the PBS Kids Raising Readers van. The WHRO education team's early childhood coordinator, Martha Razor, visited Carver to help spread the joy of reading. Through an interactive read-along, singing, and fun activities, the students were encouraged to enjoy reading every day, especially over the summer months. Ms. Razor was impressed by the young students' ability to identify the different parts of a book and praised their teachers on a job well done. And to show their commitment to develop good reading habits and grow smarter through reading, the students repeated a reading pledge. To finish up the visit, each student took a tour of the PBS Kids Raising Readers van, decorated inside and out with everyone's favorite PBS Kids characters. Students received a fun reading activity book, and each class was given new books to add to their classroom libraries. At the end of the middle school volleyball season, Gildersleeve hosted their 3rd annual Student versus Faculty Volleyball Game, which was a chance for students to gain youth development opportunities by helping with the planning and execution of the game while raising money for future youth development activities at Gildersleeve. Students helped advertise the game with flyers in the hallways, during lunchtime, and on the school's morning TV show. And after the faculty expressed their enthusiasm on the morning show, ticket sales soared as the gauntlet was thrown down. Players from both the girls and boys volleyball teams participated, along with volunteer coaches from Minchville High School. And during the game, the Comic Book Club took the opportunity to sell concession items to raise funds for their own art supplies. With students, staff, and parents cheering on both teams, the sheer force of the staff team was too much for the budding adolescents to overcome. But no matter the score, the entire event was a fun-packed afternoon for the entire Gildersleeve family, showcasing excitement and athleticism in both young and old. As the new school year begins, our superintendent has a back-to-school message for our talented teachers and staff.
Welcome to the new school year. As we prepare for the arrival of our students on September 8th, I encourage each of you to keep your focus on developing smart students who are ready for college, career, and citizenship. Our work will continue to be measured by our benchmarks for all students: achievement, advancement, and youth development. Now, last year was a great story of progress for Newport News Public Schools, and we can all be proud of the hard work that advanced our benchmarks for student achievement. Out of our 23 elementary schools, 22 improved in literacy and 18 improved in math. 8 of our elementary schools improved in all 4 subjects and 10 improved in 3 subjects. In our 8 middle schools, 3 middle schools improved in all 4 subjects, 6 improved their English scores, and 5 improved in math, science, and social studies. And at the high school level, 2 high schools improved their English performance, all 6 high schools improved in math and science, 3 improved in social studies, and all of our high schools met the graduation requirements. So all of this adds up to the addition of 3 fully accredited schools in Newport News. Now, in the area of student advancement, we're also experiencing great results. Over 2,000 of our students took 3,300 AP exams, and this is an increase of 27% since 2010. Our high school students earned over 1,500 industry certifications, and that's up from only 700 in 2010. Our freshman promotion rate is up to 92%, an increase from 86% in 2009, and 45% of our eighth graders successfully completed the high school course in Algebra 1 or Geometry. And our youth development efforts are also paying off. Over 73% of our middle school students and 83% of our high school students participated in a club or activity that connected them to their school community. And since 2009, there has been a noticeable decrease in the number of out-of-school suspensions. And 80% of our students have never even been referred to the office. So together, we have advanced opportunities for our students. And I appreciate your work in supporting our young people as they become smarter. We must remain dedicated to the belief that smart is something you can become in Newport News Public Schools. And building this culture of progress will open doors for our students. So how do we accomplish this? Let's hear from some of our students.
A good teacher to me is a teacher that helps me all the time when I need help and doesn't just push me away and say, do this, it's easy, you should have been paying attention.
If you get a problem wrong, the teacher will like say, nice try.
The best way for me to learn is being hands-on. I get it better when I'm like hands-on.
I'm a very tactical learner. I like to be hands-on. I like to be like touching it, building it.
A teacher helps me get smarter by using games to do that.
A teacher that can get on your level and reason with you and move you up.
If the student's going the wrong way, she'll be like already like, oh no, like she'll put them in the right spot.
A good school day is when everybody has a big honking smile on their face.
A good day at school is just a very active day.
What motivates me is science, and I like the experiments and stuff that we do.
The best way for me to learn is in a group, so more than one person can help me and I can help them.
Because I feel like if students work in groups together, they have a chance to help each other learn.
Every time there's a new, oh, I already want to get in because I want to try new things.
And they make what they're teaching like really apply to the people they're teaching to. So they make it like a really, really personal experience.
They relate the lessons in class to things that I do outside of just the classrooms.
So I like to think that everything I do has a purpose and a meaning to it, and that it leads to something great that I can honestly, you know, see right now, but it's going to manifest one day.
So as you prepare for a new school year, I want to thank you for your work and your dedication in ensuring that our students graduate college, career, and citizen ready. Now have a great opening and a successful school year.
As the summer season winds down, the new school year is coming up quickly. If your child isn't registered for Newport News Public Schools, do it now. Children who are 5 by September 30th are eligible to enter kindergarten. And if you're enrolling your child for the first time, the Commonwealth of Virginia has some specific guidelines for you to follow. Parents and guardians must provide a certified birth certificate, immunization records, physical exam records, and proof of legal residence. You'll need to register your child at the school he or she will be attending. To determine which school your child will attend, go to the registration page at nnschools.org and use the NNPS School Zone Finder. While you're there, you can also download a checklist along with all of the forms you'll need for registration. And please remember, a child who will be 6 years old on or before September 30th must attend school. Students and families, remember that schools will be holding open houses and orientations this week, so please take note of the following dates and times. For early childhood centers and elementary schools, open house will take place on September 3rd from 4 to 7 p.m. For middle schools, 6th grade orientation will be on September 2nd from 1 to 3 p.m., followed by an open house for all students and parents from 4 to 7 p.m. And for high schools, 9th grade or new student orientation takes place on September 4th from 8 to 11:30 a.m. For a list of these dates and a calendar of the school year, go to the school system's website at nnschools.org. Jefferson Lab is offering a science enrichment program for 5th, 6th, and 8th grade teachers. The after-school program is called Jefferson Lab Science Activities for Teachers, or JSAT, and it's designed to increase teachers' knowledge of the physical sciences while strengthening their teaching skills. The program begins in September and runs through May 2016. The deadline for applications is Friday, September 11th. More information is available online or by calling 757-269-5002. Also remember that Monday, September 7th, is Labor Day, so schools and offices will be closed. And the following day, Tuesday, September 8th, is the day that everyone anticipates, the first day of school. I hope you have a great beginning to a fantastic school year. Thanks for joining us for this week's edition of This Just In. And check out more fun and informative videos at nnpstv.com to see the many great things happening in Newport News Public Schools. Thanks for watching.